Hello everybody! In this video, I would like to show you how to create this animation in GeoGebra using some basic transformations. Here I have opened GeoGebra Classic 5 on my desktop, but you can use also GeoGebra version 6 for desktop as well. I do not recommend GeoGebra Online for this construction because it could be a little bit slow. Now, to start, we need to create three rings, which are surfaces, and we can define surfaces with GeoGebra using the command surface. And notice here I have three different options. I'm going to choose the second one because we're going to need only a circle, which is a curve. Then we're going to rotate that circle at a given angle with respect to a particular line. So, but first we need to create the circle. In order to create a circle, I'm going to type in the input box C1 equal to circle. I'm going to select the first one, which is point and radius number. And I'm going to type a 4,0, radius 1. And now I'm going to create a surface. I'm going to say S1 equal to surface. And remember, it's going to be the second one. The curve is C1. The angle is going to be 2 pi. And the line is going to be the y-axis. And there we go. We have our object, our surface. And now we cannot see it because we do not have opened the 3D graphics view. So in order to see that ring, we click on view, and then 3D graphics. And there it is. Now we're going to create the other two rings in a similar way, but we're going to choose different points. The first one is going to be 8,0. The second one is going to be 12,0 with the same radius. So C2 equal to circle, and the point is 8,0, radius 1. Hit enter, and the surface is 2 equal to surface. The curve C2, angle 2 pi, the y-axis. Then C3 equal to circle, point radius, that's going to be 12,0, radius 1. And finally, S3 equal to surface, the curve is C3, angle 2 pi, the y-axis. And there we go, we have obtained our three rings. Now we need to move these rings with a particular angle, and we have to choose the axis of rotation. So I'm going to use the X, Y, and Z axis. But first we need to define a slider. So here I click on the slider, then on the graphics view, on the name I'm going to type T. The minimum value is going to be from 0 to 2 pi, 0.01, and increment, hit OK. There we go, that is my slider, that is going to define my rotations. Now, I'm going to define a new surface that is going to be the rotation of the original three rings. So, here I'm going to type R1 equal to, I'm going to use the command rotate, and here I'm going to choose the object angle axis of rotations. The object is going to be S1, the angle is going to be T, and the axis of rotation is going to be, I'm going to choose here the X axis. And there it is. Now you can see it's already rotated because it's already a given number. So if I drag my slider, you can see how it's rotating. I'm going to hide the S1, S2, and S3 so you can appreciate better the rotations. Now I'm going to use the similar idea for R2. That is going to be equal to rotate an object, in this case S2, with respect of T, with respect of the Y axis. And let's see what happens. Seems like it's not rotating, but it is rotating because it's rotating with respect of the Y axis. We're gonna fix that soon. Let's first define the last one, which is going to be R3 equal to rotate object going to be S3 with respect of T with respect of Z axis. There we go. If we drag our slider, you can see they are rotating. So this animation looks fine, but still we would like to fix the ring in the middle. And that rotation will have to be a little bit different. So we can obtain the same animation as the one I showed you at the beginning. In order to do that change, we first need to define a line, which is going to be line defined from the point to point, that is going to be from the origin 0, 0, 0, 0 to another point. I'm going to choose just 1, 1, 1, and now what I have to do is modify the rotation. So instead of just applying one rotation here, which is given by this command rotate, I'm going to apply another rotation. So I just need to type at the beginning rotate, I open brackets, and then I'm going to rotate that with respect of T with respect of the new line that I just defined. Close my brackets, so just give me an arrow, and there we go. Now the first ring is rotating slightly different. Now let's see what happens with the second ring when I add that extra rotation. So at the beginning I rotate with respect of T with respect of that new line, hit OK, and let's see what happens. Now you can see it's no longer rotating only around the y-axis, but it's also rotating around that new line segment and that new line. And finally the R3, and for the R3 we apply the second rotation, rotate with respect to T with respect of this new line L, and there we go. And that's the animation that we just obtained and I showed you at the beginning. So just to make it a little bit better, now we can just hide all the original circles, and we can actually remove the axis, we can remove the plane, and also we can hide that extra line. And we can do a little bit better with the new surfaces, and we select the three surfaces and change the properties. So we're going to change the color, and the opacity is going to be just full, and the style, the line thickness is going to be 0, and also we can change the color of the background of the 3D graphics view. So here click on the background color and then click on black, and there we go. So it looks prettier, and that is our animation. So we just need to start the animation on. There we go. We just obtained this beautiful animation. And that's all, we made it. I hope you like this construction. Try to make some changes, for example, use a different curve instead of a circle. Try to change the colors, the background, or you can also try to use other geometric objects like cubes, for example. I would like to see what you can create. There is a link in the description below with the live demo and the script. Thanks for watching. See you next time.